In Commitment 2010, the latest WMUR Granite State poll numbers are out, giving a snapshot of where things stand less than 5 weeks before election night.
In the Senate race, of the more than 500 randomly selected New Hampshire voters polled, 50% say they would vote for Republican Kelly Ayotte, while 35% gave Democrat Congressman Paul Hodes the nod. Back in July, Ayotte had only an 8-point spread here. Josh McKelvin has a look at how things are shaping up in the congressional races.
Starting in the first congressional district race between incumbent Democrat Carol Shea-Porter and Republican Frank Ginta, we see what some might consider a bit of a surprise.
First CD is an interesting race.
According to UNH pollster Andy Smith, Frank Ginta is surging, as 49% of those asked said they would vote for the former mayor of Manchester, while 39% would vote for Carol Shea-Porter, a 15-point swing from only a couple of months ago.
This is really tough news for Shea-Porter because most of these congressional races tend to be referendums on the incumbent, and she's at below 40%. Anytime an incumbent is below 40% this close to election, it says that they're in a really difficult shape.
But Smith believes this is a race that could get ugly before it's all said and done.
This is going to be a tough race to watch. I think it's going to go nasty. I think you're going to see a lot of money being spent by outside groups in this race, and it's certainly one that people in Washington are watching very closely.
Turning now to the second CD, we have former six-term Congressman Republican Charlie Bass and Democratic newcomer Annie Custer.
The second CD, it's an open seat, but it's kind of a quasi-open seat.
If the election were held today, Smith says Bass does come out on top by a 5-point margin, 43% for Bass, 38% for Custer. But that is a huge difference from July, when Bass held an 18-point lead in a head-to-head matchup. Yes, Custer certainly got a boost from her primary victory over Katrina Swets, but Smith says she also holds the all-important card, momentum.
Bass has slipped a little bit. Custer's come up quite a bit in this district. So this one's a little bit unusual. This is one where you would think that Bass would have significant advantage, being the kind of the quasi-incumbent, a Republican in a Republican year. But you're not seeing the same enthusiasm for him that you're seeing for other Republican candidates.